Good. Thanks, Ed.
It is good. It's fun, too.
Yep. Well, people now are bypassing the travel agents and booking their summer vacation trips online. But there are some sites and information out there that can be misleading. And joining us now with more, our techspert, Dan Thompson, to talk a little bit about this. Good to see you.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
What are things when you're planning on looking for prices and places to go that you should avoid or things that you should gravitate to?
Yeah, sure. So for the longest time, and you and I have had a discussion about this site before, TripAdvisor.com was kind of like the site to go to when you're planning a trip. It's got lots of great feedback from people who have been places. So it's a good place just to go to kind of get ideas. However, here lately, people have been noticing that a lot of these reviews are fake. And so kind of the general thinking is maybe somebody who runs the hotel has made this review or something along those lines. So the question then becomes, well, how do you know what's a real review, what's a fake review? Recently, it was actually about a month ago, some people in Glasgow, Scotland, did a bunch of fake reviews on a homeless shelter. They called it a hostel. And for about a week, this homeless shelter was like one of the top places to stay in Glasgow as, as ranked by TripAdvisor. Yeah, so it's like, oh, well, that's not good. So this kind of really brought everything to light. So what kind of my new strategy and what I kind of recommend for people to do is use TripAdvisor as kind of your starting point. So read, and what I generally do is read, you know, kind of the bad reviews. So like you look and see what people are saying negatively about the place, and you can kind of get a vibe sometimes. There's some people that just aren't going to be happy no matter what, right?
Right.
And if it looks like the reviews are full of just that's the only people who are saying bad things, it's probably a good place. You know, it's probably a decent place to go. Another a great resource are blogs. So there's lots of people who do a lot of traveling. You can find them on their blog. And the nice thing about blogs is you can then have an interaction with them, ask them questions, and you know, okay, this is a real person. They've really been there. Twitter is also a great resource. I know you spend a lot of time on Twitter. but if you search for the hashtag RTW, that stands for Round the World, people, you'd be surprised them are people who have quit their jobs. They do nothing but travel around the world, and they write about it.
You're kidding.
Yeah, I know. It's awesome. It's, I mean, it's like, this is like the dream job, right? So so what these guys do is they write about it. You can talk to them on Twitter. Likelihood is they've been to wherever it is you're going, and you can ask them for, you know, advice and tips, and they can give them to you. And then you know you've spoken to a real person, and it's not just some person trying to, you know, get the rank on their hotel up.
Wow. Who do they get paid by?
I have no idea. What a lot of them do is they'll save up money for a year or two, you know, get about $15,000, $20,000 saved up, and then just leave, sell all their stuff and leave. And you'd be surprised how long $20,000 will last you in, you know, third world countries around the world. So
unbelievable.
Yeah, very cool stuff.
All right, Dan, thanks very much. You're going to stick around?
I am.
For Fox? All right. Well, still coming up on 10 News Today, people are wondering what exactly Attorney General Eric Holder knew and why he didn't share it. We're going to tell you who Holder has to answer to today and through the rest of the week. But first, here's more.